And let's try to get a clearer picture of the COVID-19 surge spreading throughout China. We're joined by Yang Shengxi, a correspondent of China Global Television Network in Beijing. Yang, good evening, and thank you for joining us.
Glad to be here.
Can you tell us whether or not the hospitals throughout China have the capability to deal with the number of COVID cases there? Because we're receiving reports that they are now accepting or at least being crowded with 5 to 6 times more patients than usual.
Well, I can tell you about the situation here in Beijing, because hospitals in Beijing are still operating under, of course, a lot of pressure, with reports of doctors and nurses having to stay on their shifts even after contracting COVID themselves. According to two major hospitals in the city, Tiantan Hospital and Shenwu Hospital, daily patients going to their fever clinics are currently about 200 to 250 per day. And that is lower than the peak of 300 to 500 daily patients last week, but the number is still substantially higher than normal, which was around 30 to 50 patients a day. So the influx of patients is still stretching thin vital medical resources. Hospitals now need to find ways to expand their intensive care units and add more beds. And at the same time, most hospitals in the city say they have opened fast-track admissions for other emergency cases like strokes and special care persons like pregnant women. Tony?
Yang, can you tell us more about these fever clinics? What do they look like and where are these being set up?
Well, most hospitals in China have an emergency section for emergencies like the ones I mentioned, like strokes, but they also have a separate entrances for people with fevers. Those are called fever clinics. So this is a standard practice across hospitals in China. And for example, this month, health authorities in Beijing have said that the fever clinics in Beijing have actually tripled over the past months in order to cater to all the new patients with fevers coming into these hospitals.
Now, you've given us an idea of how the hospitals are dealing with the rise in COVID cases. But then again, we're also receiving reports that people don't seem to be bothered by that at all, because there are a lot of people now traveling and crowding into subway stations. Is that correct?
Well, yes. While this COVID wave is hitting hard on senior citizens and those with underlying medical conditions, streets are, of course, emptier than usual. But there are quite a number of residents who are taking advantage of the cancellation of much of the social restrictions. For example, I checked on one of the major shopping areas in Beijing last night. It was Christmas night. While China does not celebrate Christmas, this holiday has usually been a day when people just go out for shopping and some family fun. Since the area I visited no longer has COVID negative requirements and health QR code to scan, there were substantially more people than the same periods in the last 2 years, as far as I can tell. Now, shops were crowded, restaurants were full, vendors were out in droves. So no doubt, many residents are seizing the opportunity to try to bring back their pre-pandemic lifestyles. But most people I saw there were, of course, wearing masks, except for when they were taking selfies. You know, mask wearing has been very much a part of the life here in China for the past few years. Mm-hmm. So many people are sticking to it during this COVID peak, and health experts have urged people to keep each other protected so as not to stretch thin the supply of vital medicine.
All right. And very quickly, Yang, can you tell us whether or not this latest COVID surge has actually encouraged or even made people think more about getting vaccinated?
Well, there have been some confusion, actually, among netizens about whether they should still get vaccine boosters at this moment, as they fear that vaccines might in the short term affect their immune system when a COVID infection could be imminent. Others wonder if they should still get a booster after recovering from COVID and thus having antibodies. But the message from health authorities and experts remain the same, which is that most people should get boosted if possible. This will enhance the country's overall immune barrier, and this will become very important as the 2023 Spring Festival is coming up in January, a time when Chinese people travel back to their hometowns for reunions. It is sometimes called the biggest annual human migration on Earth. As many travel restrictions are lifted this year, many Chinese will be seizing this opportunity to travel and meet their relatives, and in some cases for the first time in 2 or 3 years. Health experts have been urging people who have not been boosted to do so as to avoid another COVID peak early next year.
All right. Thank you very much, Yang Shengxi from CGTN in Beijing. Thank you very much.